You've got to be a person who understands all parts of your business. You've got, I mean, you've got to understand human resources, accounting. You've got to understand compliance. You have to understand sales. You have to understand business development. You got to be the person who understands each piece of your business. And even as you hire people, you still don't want to be a person who doesn't understand what the IT person does, and they're talking over you, because, if you hire vendors and hire other people, they could, tell you certain things that may not necessarily be advantageous to your business, or they may, hey, you need to spend money on this, that, and the other. And if you don't understand, you're just going along with what they say because you don't understand what they're saying. So I think, in entrepreneurship, you need to understand all the other components of your area, of your occupational specialty. You need to understand all the other components of entrepreneurship as well in your business. That goes into leadership. So when you do understand all the different pieces, you're a better leader. You can lead your people better and say, listen, this is where I want to go with the business. So I like your idea, but this is my vision. This is where I want to take this, and we want to do A, B, C, and D. See how you can work this within that model, okay? And I think, for a good leader is also a person who can communicate. Some core values is being able to communicate your message. That's another good piece, communication, and also just communicating with your customer, communication with your employees, communication with vendors who you're going to be using. All those pieces are valuable in terms of good core leadership traits. If you're a young entrepreneur, you're going to be having people work for you, whether they're working for, minimum wage or you're paying them a high salary. You've got to make sure you take care of your people. Your people are your best assets. I mean, most entrepreneurs are going to grow and possibly have people working for them at some point in time. Or they may have even just people who are kind of just working for nothing because they believe in you. But you've got to take care of your people. And if you take care of your people and create that sense of loyalty, then your people will jump through amazing hurdles for you and then push out your product and push out what you're doing. You want to be a leader that inspires, that goes in and checks on you. And, hey, how are things going? What's going on at home? Everything's good? So you want to have that same approach. Your entrepreneurship is the same, it's a battle. And I need to rely on you to for the life of this company, for the life of all of us. And so if you do that, then it will work out.